People that are successful financially, well-educated, they worked hard to get up to where they are now. And when things are going right for them, they don't want to be burdened with being sick. Good information that's filtered. There's a lot of garbage out there, a lot of stuff on the internet and books and magazines that really is not all that good. If they are sick, they're offline.
They're out of business.
They're not going to be making money, and they're very concerned for the success they have, for their family, their employees, and for themselves.
We're in this together. This is why we build communities. And when it comes to inspiring people to improve their health and their fitness, their wellness, the more that we can create this kind of sense of community, the better shot we have at solving this problem. Because if we don't do this, this problem is not going to get solved.
And again, can we give them information to change their life one way? To eat better, exercise, or a greater awareness of their health and wellness, and realize how much control they have. Welcome, everybody, to Your Health First. I'm Dr. Joe Galati. We're here every Sunday bringing you the best in health and wellness, and of course, the financial implications of health and wellness. And I'm here tonight with my co-host, as usual. Chuck Garcia is a 25-year Wall Street veteran, turned college professor of finance. Chuck, how are you tonight?
I'm very well, Joe. Thank you. It's always great to be here.
The one product of clothing that was out there more than anything was Lululemon.
There are rumors in the press that Apple is getting together with Nike.
Right.
And Samsung, in response to that, said, hey, I wonder what they're doing. Let's get together with Under Armour. So here you have the world's largest technology companies trying to figure out how to integrate technology with the clothing, apparel, fitness industry like an Under Armour and a Nike.
The smart watch industry keeps track of your heart rate, the calories, the steps. We're medicalizing, in a sense, a lot of the technology and the fun stuff. In the studio is John Grover with Raymond James talking about the financial implications of diabetes. Chuck, this is a global problem. Chuck, what do you think?
Well, I think the saddest part about diabetes, it's to those of us who are walking around the street, it's not visible.
Mm-hmm.
You can't see it.
Right.
There's no color to it. Many people don't even know they have it.
Right.
But the really sad part, it is a devastating disease that continues by order of magnitude get grander and bigger, and more people have it, which means more drugs, more medicine, more sick people.
John, what companies are leading the way here?
Well, right now, the biggest company that is involved in insulin production is Novo Nordisk, which is a company out of Denmark.
Right.
By far the biggest producer of the insulin products, a $30 billion plus, as I said, just in the United States. Historically, these companies, the biotechnology companies and companies that are involved in drug production, have done very well. Like I said, Novo Nordisk, which is the biggest company, their stock, just for an example, this year, in the last 12 months, up 32%.
Right. That's good, right?
Unbelievable.
That's very good.
That is quite good. Anybody will take that.
32%. Right. That's good.
You give me a dollar a year later, I got $1.32. Mm-hmm. I'll take that any day of the week.
People have diabetes. And the one thing for everybody listening, there's this something that my patients say. They will say, I have just a touch of diabetes.
Mm.
And that's like saying you have a touch of cancer, okay? Every week, we like to talk about what the world is talking about. And Chuck, Ebola, in the news, radio, TV, magazine, newspapers, were saturated with Ebola. Now, as we've talked about before, the drug company Gilead came out with a drug, Sovaldi, at the end of 2013. The problem is they're quoting that the cost of the pill is $1,000 a pop.
It beat what we call the consensus estimates.
Right.
It beat expectations. Anytime there is a sale that beats expectations, this is the case of if it's not broken, don't fix it.
Right.
They are selling more and more of these, billions of dollars. They are now have recorded revenues of close to $7 billion. A few years ago, they were at only two. If we continue on this freight train, that by the year 2050, one-third of all Americans will have diabetes.
Yeah,
haven't we had enough?
Might you be talking about the Brûléed French Toast by Cheesecake Factory? All right, so this is 2,700 calories, 93 grams of fat, which is basically a week's worth of fat in your breakfast. Honey, I love you, and we're going to go for breakfast. I mean, every time I look at this, I crack up. To neutralize the calories, you'd have to swim laps for 7 hours.
Yeah, you
back
know.
You drown before you burn this off.
People that are successful and well-to-do tend to be the most healthy in investing in things that matter to them. What matters to them, given the matter of self-respect, is their health. They understand health companies. They understand the financial implications.
You have the absolute power to control your destiny with regard to your health and wellness. Never feel so out of control that you have no impact. Listen, learn, take action. All right, Chuck, another great week. Thanks for joining me tonight.
My pleasure,
Don't
Joe.
Forget,
great
everybody,
to be here.
Go to yourhealthfirst.com, sign up for a newsletter, let us know what is on your mind. We'll see you again next Sunday evening.